discussion. Ordinary things meeting and the physical interplay between personalities. It would be inevitable that there would be too much conversation, and the work done would not be adequately effective. From the physical standpoint, they work alone. From the true inner standpoint, they work in the process of cooperation. Here are the first words which I would have the student master. Preliminary rules for radiatory healing. 1. By an act of the will, after making your own quick, conscious alignment, link up as a soul with the souls of your group brothers. Link up with their minds, and then with their emotional natures. Do this by the use of the imagination, realizing that energy follows thought and that the linking process is inevitable, if correctly done. You can then function as a group. Then forget about the group relation and concentrate upon the work to be done. 2. Within yourself, then, group soul and brain and gather together the forces of love that are to be found in your aura and focus yourself and all that you have to offer within your head. Picture yourself as a radiant center of energy or a point of vivid light. Projected upon the patient through the acne center between the eyes. 3. Then say the following good mantra. With purity of motive, inspired by a loving heart, we offer ourselves for this work of healing. This offer we make as a token to the one we serve. As you do this, visualize the linking process going on. See it as moving lines of living light substance, linking you to your brothers on the one hand, and to the patient on the other. See these lines going out from you to the heart center of the group and to the patient. Be sure never from the acne center until instructed deliberately. In this way, the acne center and the heart center of all the persons involved will be closely interrelated. Where the value of visualization comes in. It is in reality the etheric externalization of the physical imagination. Copyright 1998 Lucis Trust. 63. A Treatise on the Seven Rays. Volume 4. Esoteric Healing. Think this last sentence out. 4. Then use thought. Directed thought. Think of the one you seek to heal, linking up with him, and focusing your attention on him so that he becomes a reality in your consciousness and close to you. When you are aware what the physical difficulty is, then simply recall it to your mind and then dismiss it. Forget now the details of the work, such as the group, yourself and the difficulty of the patient. And concentrate upon the type of force you are going to handle, which is, in this case and for the present, second rate force, the force of love. What I am here giving out is an adaptation of the second rate method of healing, arranged in layers. 5. Feel a deep love pouring into you. Regard it as substantial light which you can manipulate. Then send it out as a stream of radiant light from the acne center and direct it through the medium of your hand to the patient. In doing this, hold the hand before the eyes, palms outward and move the halves of the hands next to the eyes and about 6 inches away from the face. In this way, the stream which is issuing from the acne center becomes divided into two. attitude or properly controlled.